What can you do with an RNN? Lots of things. Imagine that you have a model that predicts the next step of your sequence, for example. You can use that to generate sequences, for example, text, either one word at a time or one character at a time. For that, you take your sequence at time t, you generate the predictions from your RNN, and then you sample from the predicted distribution, meaning you pick one element based on its probability, and feed that sample to the next step and go on. Do this repeatedly. Predict, sample, predict, sample, and you can generate a pretty good sequence of whatever your RNN models. There is a more sophisticated way to do this that gives better results, because just sampling the next prediction every time is very greedy. Instead of just sampling once at each step, you could imagine sampling multiple times. Here you pick O, but also A, for example. Then you have multiple sequences, often called hypotheses, that you could continue predicting from at every step. You can choose the best sequence out of those by computing the total probability over all the characters that you've generated so far. By looking at the total probability over multiple time steps at a time, you prevent the sampling from accidentally making one bad choice and being stuck with that one bad decision forever. For example, we could have just picked A by chance here and never explored the hypothesis that O could lead to a very sensible next word. Of course, if you do this naively, the number of sequences that you need to consider grows exponentially. There is a smarter way to do that, which is to do what's called a beam search. You only keep, say, the most likely few candidate sequences at every time step, and then simply prune the rest. In practice, this works very well for generating very good sequences from your model.